toy fans, Aaron here. Tonight, taking a look at the Darth Maul Sith Apprentice figure that was released in 2001 on the Power of the Jedi line. So let's head to the table and check this one out. And here's a look at Darth Maul on that Power of the Jedi card. This was the combination of the Episode 1 line along with the original trilogy, so that you had one look for all the figures on the shelves. Came on a nice green card back with an image of the prequel Obi-Wan Kenobi in front of Darth Vader. Off on the left side, you can see included was the Jedi Force file. This was the 8-page info booklet containing some statistics and information about the included figure. And then that included figure being Darth Maul is what you see in the blister off to the right. On the back of the card, top right side, you get a little bit of a description about this line. Basically, what I already said, combining Phantom Menace along with the original trilogy figures. Just below that, you get a look at the back side of that Force file. So you get a little bit of a write-up about Darth Maul showing through there. And then off on the left side of the card, you get a listing of about 16 figures that were also available in the line right around this time. And now taking a look at the figure out of the packaging, and you know, things are looking pretty good. While we are getting later in the line, it is still 2001, so things are a bit early. Figures were not as overly articulated as they are, well, kind of now, I suppose. And this Sith Apprentice outfit is based on some of the concept art for Darth Maul, as he was being imagined for Episode 1. So this was certainly great for Hasbro to include this in the line. It was always nice when they included some expanded universe figures, some concept figures. And along with this, you ended up getting a nice backstory of this being a Sith Apprentice outfit as he gears up to become a Sith Lord. Taking a look at the head sculpt, nothing really new here. It is the face that we've come to know and love of Darth Maul. Pretty decent painting in there for that red and black tattoo. Horns are looking pretty good. And nice little brown painting for the tips of those horns also on the top of his head. And you see a couple there off to the side on his temple area. The pattern for that red tattoo is still coming through pretty well. The mouth area, I'd say things probably a little too much black in there, something not quite right. Obviously, that's something that's probably going to vary figure to figure. His eyes are painted in a nice Sith color, but unfortunately on my figure, his left eye, or right as you look at it on the screen, is looking off to the side and not straight ahead like his other eye. Wrapped around his neck, you're going to see the collar of that padded armor that he's wearing. That has translated very well from what we're seeing with the little winged thing sticking out of his neck. And then through the chest and arms, once again, that padding is really coming through. Yeah, lots of great detailing in there for some of that, the puffiness, if you will. And the various armor pieces, or the shoulder armor. You got some nice lines of definition in there. So I think they did a pretty good job of bringing the design of that concept art into action figure form. Along the back side of the figure, nothing really different here. Just some different seams sculpted in there, some ruffles and stuff of the fabric sculpted in. So things really are looking pretty good to me. On his forearms, you can see he's got some black gloves painted in there. Never mind the silver that you see stuck to his hands. Unfortunately, that just didn't stay put on his lightsaber. Each arm is already pre-sculpted in a 90-degree bend. I'll go through the articulation in a bit, but pretty much all you're going to really get out of him is a double-fisted hold with that lightsaber. Through the waist, pretty decent belt sculpted in there. You know, I feel like his gold belt buckle sits a little low, but I haven't found a good image to know if that's actually where it should be placed or not. But I kind of just want to move that up a little bit. Aside from that, though, you get a good feeling of those robes kind of being bunched up underneath that belt and then coming out the bottom side, and then carry on for the rest of the bottom part of those robes. Texture changes up a little bit here, but it's looking pretty good. So you certainly get the feeling that the wrap pieces are a different type of material mixed with what I would say is probably an inner robe of some kind. So pretty good draping to it, nice sculpting, a little bit of flowiness to it. And then for his legs, you can see he's all black through here, but he's got some additional armor pieces. He's got some knee pads or something sculpted in there. And then his boots are looking like they're a little more warrior type or protective gear of some sort. Not quite what we're used to seeing for the regular Darth Maul look, but still pretty good sculpting to see. Something nice, something different, I think. As for articulation, you're not getting anything in the head. This head and his neck piece are actually sculpted in as one piece, and that wraps over the shoulder, so no twisting or anything there. But both of the shoulders do rotate all the way around. And then for the elbows, only his left arm swivels. But he does stay in that, I guess we'll call it a 90-degree position. You do get full swivel at the waist. As for the legs, you've got a little slit, of course, as you can see. So that allows for a little bit of movement, but things are pretty tight and it pushes back. So they only bend out about like so on its own. Nothing to speak of going back once again because of that hard plastic. And that's all you get for the legs. Nothing at the knee, nothing at the feet, because it was just a different time. As for accessories, it does come with this double-bladed lightsaber. Not the deepest red to it, and in fact, my lights kind of make it a little more pink than it actually is. But for the most part, things are looking pretty good with the coloring. The hilt of the blade has a nice silver paint job to it. As I mentioned earlier, though, you're going to see that paint peeled off where his hands have been sitting for the last almost 20 years, I suppose, 19 years. So aside from that, though, the rest of that silver painting's looking pretty good. Got some nice lines of black in there, and little bits of red buttons painted in. Lightsaber does fit well in both of his hands, so he still has a pretty decent double-handed pose with it, which is good because that's exactly how they sculpted him to hold it. And then otherwise, not necessarily an accessory, but here's a look at that force file that he came with. This front of it is what you saw in the carded look, and that does open up to reveal various panels of information. If I could just flip that open there. But as you can see, you got some statistics, some skills, the gear that he uses, the tech that he uses, a little thing you can send off for the Jedi Quest Kids Club. And then you flip that over, you get a look at his allies and enemies, some of the adventures that he's been on, and then now we delve into some information about Darth Maul as a Sith Apprentice, including some vital statistics. Gotta say, I always liked that this was included. I like getting information about your figure, something that you can look at. So if it's not going to be on the back of the card, I like that it's included in a little pamphlet like this. So overall, it's a pretty good-looking figure. He's got a bit of an action-oriented pose to him, and I like that you're getting a Darth Maul from the concept, or in this case now, an expanded universe look. There's no denying that he was one of the most popular characters right out of Episode 1, so I'm glad that Hasbro made the effort to make this part of the action figure line, and then Hasbro also added in a Qui-Gon and an Obi-Wan for some concept art look also, or maybe Obi-Wan was just expanded universe. Nevertheless, though, I'm glad that they stepped out of the realm of the actual movies and how we saw the characters on film, and gave us a few more action figures based on an expanded universe look. And so that wraps up this look at the Darth Maul Sith Apprentice action figure. I'd love to know what your thoughts are on it in the comment section below. And as always, thank you for watching.